Good morning, children. In the previous video, we had discussed about what is federalism, how it works in India, coming together, holding together. We discussed the list, union list, state list, and concurrent list. Even though I talked to you, some other works which is not divided or included in these three lists is included into residuary power. Okay. As I told you, after the session, many children are asking questions. I'm really very happy. Now, if you have again any doubt, you can concern to me. Okay, let's start with the next part of federalism. We discussed about how government system works. Now we'll talk about after independent, what we did it. How we frame these provinces, how we divided provinces or state, we'll look after. Just see. Now when we talked about it, how does India practice power sharing? We'll talk about it. Children, by creating linguistic states, no, linguistic state with the name only you are getting it, the state formation on the basis of language, but you know the diversity is more. So when will be applicable, when we started, like by creating linguistic states which has made administration easier because same language peoples together at one place, so applicable, and they are also accepting because their group is together. And it's very easy to give decision according to that particular group. So new states have been created since 1947. You know what is 1947? Independent, our country's declaration. So no language has been given the status of national language by the constitution when it was framed. Restructuring of power sharing between central and state, as we discussed. Rise of regional political parties and coalition government has led to a new culture of power sharing. Before BJP, we read about the coalition power. Coalition power, you know, that where the ruling parties, they share their powers with many parties as according to complete the target. Restructuring of power sharing between central and state, we discussed like in previous video, we discussed about it, how power shared with the state and central. Now, threefold distribution of legislative power also we know. Threefold distribution of legislative power, this we discussed in the previous video. We discussed about how they works and how the power is sharing about it, legislative power. Now we'll talk about the linguistic states. Now after the independent, what we did it? Many new states have been formed. How? Boundaries have been changed, people of common language have been brought together, states created on the basis of culture, ethnicity, geography has made the country united and administration also easy to handle these type of people when they are together. Talk example, some other countries which are formed according to the culture or ethnicity or the geography, example is there that Nagaland, Uttarakhand and Jharkhand. So linguistic states, when we started, that was little bit comfortable to government to give any or to pass any law, because it was like this, that in this government is in this state, these type of peoples are there, this language is there, so we'll go with this policy. So that was very easy. Language policy was what? No language has been given the status of national language. Okay. Central government can't impose Hindi on non-Hindi speaking states. There was that South Indian peoples, you know that they don't know Hindi, so won't be able to declare Hindi as a national language, but there should be something that. So as we have seen, 22 languages have been recognized as scheduled languages. One more question answers will be there for you. Central agreed to use English along with the Hindi by this flexibility is shown. Now it is not compulsory that this, if you'll go in any government offices, it goes according to the state languages or which languages are comfortable. So it's not language and language foundation is there in the any government offices or any language under language policy, they are bounding the people that you should speak this or you should speak in this language only. So very comfortable, the center agreed to use English as everyone knows, and if not then Hindi or any flexibility which is there. Now next, when we'll talk about the relationship between the state and the central relation. Central government cannot be undermine the power of state or the dismiss them. Sometime it happens that central government talk about that at leading, who is leading there? BJP. And some of the state where Congress is leading. So don't, it should not be like this that the rivals are there, so central government will not look after that state where which is ruled by any on one of the rival party, and may they will dismiss. No, it should not be like this. Reason should be there, it is proper discussion should be there, then only. coalition government power is sharing is more effective today. But as we have seen, now we are under the supreme one power only. So coalition government which was there under when the previous, when Congress party was there, when that time we have seen the coalition government where when more than one party was there in ruling party. But today only a majority is there of BJP. Coalition government power sharing is more effective today. It is what the previous party. Now, what brought about the real success of federalism in India? Now, we are able to work successfully under the federalism in India. Why? Because we follow democratic form of government where everybody has a right to give decision and we only elected the people to talk about us, to give decision for us, to think about our welfare. So this is what nature of democratic politics we followed. Real success, this type of question also will be asked to you, real life questions, so you just think about it. You have to elaborate this point. Respect for democratic politics, as we have accepted, it means everybody is following the same and government also feels comfortable to give their decision. So respect for democratic politics and desire for living together. We all are working together because you know that when we discuss the features of constitution, under that one point is there secularism, which gives us to, we all are able to enjoy our freedom to speech, freedom to live, you have right to life and all. So here we all are desire for living together, there is no problem. So because of this, when we go with these three points, it lets you that this is only the real success, that federalism working properly in India. So we are able to see this. Now, what undermines the spirit of federalism? Center misusing the constitution to dismiss the state that was controlled by rival party. Just I told you this point. Coalition government led to a new culture of power sharing and respect for the autonomy of the state government, that I told you. Now we are under this one power is there of party, that is BJP. Now, when we realize about the power sharing, now up till now there was two division was there, that was of central and the state. Then we realize it as our population is increasing and the area is also under, where population increasing, it means more area, more people are there. So what should be there? We should go for the decentralization. Decentralization in India, it was implemented. Now what is decentralization? Decentralization means that when power is taken away from the central and state government and is given to whom? It is given to local government. It means third tier, I told you. Why it is done it? This decentralization policy adopted in India. For what reason it is adopted? May the question will be asked to you. Vastness of the states in size and population. Internal diverse and diversity people. The more people are there, more variations there needed. The division, more problem, more queries are there and is impossible to handle by the state government. Think about that, the whole Maharashtra will be controlled by Maharashtra state government is impossible. And because of that, decentralization, under decentralization, what we did it, we divided the power. We extracted some of the power from central and the state and it is given to the third tier, that is the local government. Why? These three reasons are there. Now, what are the basic idea behind this decentralization? Why did it? The most important thing, the solving large number of problems and issues at local level. People have better knowledge of problems in localities. Like, if I have any problem, I won't be able to go here at Bombay and talk about my problems. People have better knowledge of problem in localities. Like if I'm having any problem here in Pusat, so I will talk with the here people, local government, that my problem is this, whether it is of water, whether it is of electricity. I won't be able to go at the state level and talk about my problems. So it's better that where I should go and easily my problem will be solved. So that is the decentralization we did it. So local people then can concern with the local government. Better ideas on where to spend money and how to manage the things efficiently. Like if I wanted to talk about the Yavatmal district and I want to take any decision about under the district. So here it is quite difficult for the state to look after this every detail about it. But here the local government are able to give and present their idea. These are the implementation is required here. We can spend money on this part. Here the sub-development is required. Here the irrigation facility should be given. Here in agriculture production we can do it, here we can go for a secondary section. So this idea will be given by local government to the state government, easily it will be applicable and a good decision will be taken, better. people participation in decision making will be there. Local peoples will also be active to give their decision. Where they are not able to ask question or discuss their queries at the state level, at the local level they are able to do. More discussion will be there and more easily they will solve their problem. To realize one important principle of democracy, local government framed. Now what? When it is more effective? Brought in effective decentralization when Act passed in 1992. Steps taken for this by the constitutions are. What it is mentioned when 1992 Act was given? It is mandatory that hold regular election in to the local government. When it was implemented, regular election was not there, so that was the problem. This is strict action taken in 1992, and it is mandatory that regular election should be there. And as there is a reservation there in the parliament, same it should be there in the local also, SC, ST, OBCs. 1/3 seats for the women also should be reserved. State election commission conduct elections. Who conducts election at the local level? State election commissions conduct the elections. State government shares some power and revenue with the local bodies. Okay, state government shares some power and revenue also with the local. Whether local government is extracted from the state, but state guides to the local government, and even though as they have given some power, so obviously to run that local government it is a must to go with the capital also. So revenue also shared, like some of the part will be given to the state, some of the part will be given to the local governments. As we were talking about it, how local government works in rural area and urban area, we'll talk in these two records. We'll talk in these two ways, okay? Rural government and urban government. Now, when we talked about this local self-government in rural area, Panchayati Raj, how it works village level, block level or district level, we'll talk about it. Village level, Gram Panchayat is there, formed by Gram Sabha, and head will be Sarpanch. If we'll talk about the block level, Panchayat Samiti is there, elected by Panchayat members only, and head will be BDO. District, when we talked about, Jila Parishad is there, formed by elected members and have a member of Lok Sabha and MLA of the district. This is what the Jila chairperson. When we talked about urban, towns and big cities, so municipality is there and municipal corporation is there. Municipal chairperson is the head, and here mayor is the head in the big cities. So rural and urban local governments. What difficulty faced by the local governments? Election to Gram Sabha are not held regularly as it was mentioned in the Act of 1992. Most of the state government are not transferring power and resources. Like every state is not, I told you now, when power is not equal in every state, so they are some of the states feeling hesitate to share their powers with the local, because as they have less power and that power is also given, from that only power is given to the local government. So some state governments were not cooperating to this decision of 1992, difficulty faced. So here children, decentralization today it is more effective. More people are able to get the benefit of government policies, that is all because of decentralization, which is quite impossible under union and the state government to discuss about these far away people, those who are living in the remote areas. So this decentralization in India under the federalism, it really works. Our India is a good example for you, where we are able to see that how every corner is now able to get the policy of government. This is all because of we adopted the federalism. Hope it is clear to you. Federalism, holding together, coming together, the list which we discussed about the rural and urban areas, local government. If you have any doubt, you will concern to me, you just send me your queries to my WhatsApp number. I'll definitely call you and solve your queries. Thank you.